Hello students, welcome to my lecture series on cinema management. Today we will be discussing on pricing and distribution in film cinema. So let us start with our topic. Here let us talk about film production from the financial point of view. Okay, so when we talk about producing the films, these are the phases wherein the finance is released, the amount of budget allotted is released on the following parameters. The first point is when the producer locks the script, when the entire script is ready and when the script is handed over to the producer. So at that point of time, in my yesterday's lecture also, I discussed about the same, that 25% of the amount is released to the writer at that point of time. So here, from the financial point of view, during the production process of the film, the first point, the first phase of film, finance release is happening when the producer locks the script. When the producer says, okay, this is the final script and we are ready to work upon that, at that point of time the first amount is released. Second amount is released when the finalizing of the director is done. When the director is contracted, when the director says, okay, I'm ready to make this film, when I'm ready to work upon this film, then at that point of time another certain amount of money is released. Third point is when they sign the lead actresses, the actors, the senior technicians in the film, when the cinematographer, DOP artist, sound designer, the lead actors, talent, okay, when all a certain set of people, basically above the line people, are hired, when they are contracted. So at that point of time also they release the funds. When the music production is being prepared, okay, when the music people are prepared, when the music talent is there, they are being hired at that point of time also, certain amount of funds are released. Then we have to understand a very important part, which we'll be discussing on the same topic today in our video this time, that is film pricing. In my yesterday's video, I talked about film budget and film pricing. So budget is somewhere wherein we are talking about money spent on the production process. But film pricing, that includes all certain kind of rights when it comes to distribution rights, satellite rights, all such kind of rights are also there. So you have to quote a certain price amount of your price for your film. So at that point of time, when the film pricing is fixed, then also certain amount of funds are released. Then during the film distribution process, theatrical release and non-theatrical release. These are the following points that we will be focusing today in our lecture. That would be film pricing, film distribution, theatrical release and non-theatrical release. Moving forward to the distribution process here, the film producer is different from the film distributor. We have to understand that sometimes what happens is that even the producers also plays a role of a distributor, unless and until they are big production houses. When the production when the producer himself is a distributor, otherwise the film producer is usually a different person from the film distributor. A producer is the one who's involved in making of the film, but a distributor is one who has contacts with the theater people, with the digital media, and they try to have a link with the different channels and there wherein your film is going to be screened on the other platforms. So the distributor is most of the time he is different from the film producer. Now here film producer can also do the distribution too, as I already said. The film distributors buy the film from the producers to exhibit. Here exhibition means that we are going to release it on the theatrical screen and other platforms. So film exhibitors and distributors, they both work in collaboration, they both work together, and the distribution controller is also involved in the distribution process. Unlike we had a production controller in the production process, Here we have again an important person who is also known as a distribution controller, who is also the charge of the distribution process. The factors that affect the film marketing, you know, there are certain factors that affects film marketing, publicity, promotion impacts, you know, has a higher impact on the film distribution prospect. Because if your film marketing is done properly, if your publicity is done properly, if your promotion of the film is done properly, of course, there would be different distributors who would be ready to invest their money in your film, and they would be interested in distributing your films to the various platforms. Then the film is being distributed on three different platforms, that not platform, in three different categories. First is domestic level, on the worldwide level, and the third one is regional distribution. So we also talk about different kind of rights which are available. The first one is theatrical right, and the second one is non-theatrical right. In the first one, theatrical right, whenever a film is produced, usually theatrical rights are once given to any, you know, particular theater. They are usually given for the domestic India and Nepal, and also it can be given to the overseas, that is rest of the world. Then we have non-theatrical rights also, which also includes a satellite, digital, and music. Here, when we talk about theatrical rights, we are only talking about the film, and we are not talking about satellite, digital, and music, you know, rights. You might have seen that there are times wherein Sony, T-Series, and Zee Music, they are interested in, you know, purchasing the music rights, and on their platforms, on their channels, they tend to, you know, play the songs. So here, these particular rights are being borne by such channels. Now, theatrical rights are split by in the two sections that you can see on your screen. The first one is domestic distribution, and the another one is overseas distribution. In domestic distribution, the rights to release the film are given in all the parts of the country. We are talking about India and Nepal. And here the key right in terms of exploitation, that means here the word exploitation simply means that once the rights are given to any company, any distributing companies, they have the right to display broadcast your film n number of times as much as they want. And this contributes to approximately 48% of the overall revenues that they earn. Here in this particular point, in the second point, the key light in the terms of exploitation, I would like to mention one example. I'm sure that you might have seen a Surya Vansham film so many times on your television screen. Why Sony is famous for this, because here they usually tend to show Surya Vansham again and again on a repeated manner. So that is why here they have, since they had purchased the domestic or distributional rights, so they have the liberty to, you know, telecast a film n number of times as much as they want. The second point comes as, which is known as overseas distribution. Here the rights to release the film are given in all the parts of the world except India and Nepal. Usually, rights are also not given in Pakistan, because we are not dealing with them right now. None of the business activity, especially related to theater, is not happening along with Pakistan. But here in overseas distribution, apart from India and Nepal, all the other countries are also in included. Especially in China and other parts of the world, wherein people are more interested in watching such films. The overseas release is limited with the domestic release, and it contributes to approximately 14% of the overall revenue. As you can see the figures on the screen, when we talk about the revenue generation, 48% of the total revenue is being brought by domestic distribution, and 14% of the overall revenue is being earned by overseas distribution. Dangal is such kind of a film which has been uploaded, which has been seen a lot of times in the China market. So it is a kind of a, success wherein this film was able to bring. Here, let us see on the screen a chart is given which talks about Indian, especially Hindi film territories. Whenever a certain kind of a distribution company is there, you know, they tend to have their setup in these 13 circuits, which has a kind of a contribution in their revenues. If when we talk about Bombay, it is 35%. In Delhi, UP, it is 20%. East Punjab, we have 9%. Mysore, 7%. Rajasthan, it is 5%. Central Province, we have 5%. Nizam states, we have 5%. West Bengal, we have 5%. Central India, we have 4%. Bihar, we have 2%. Tamil Nadu and Kerala, we have 1.5%. In Assam, we have 0.75%. And in Orissa, we again have 0.5%, which contributes to 100% of the distribution contribution in these 13 circuits. When the film is released, the distribution rights are given. They are usually been, you know, the theatrical rights are given in these states, which covers the entire country. And this is the kind of a contribution that every state makes from a particular film. Coming on to role of a distributor before the release of the film, pre-release of the film, that a distributor need to release the strategy first, how to make a particular kind of a film successful. Therefore, he has to release a strategy. Then he needs to also select the key creative for the print and television campaigns to maximize the revenue. You might have seen that, you know, in there are so many films wherein different kind of creative campaigns were held to maximize the revenue profits. And for example, in Three Idiots, Aamir Khan had done certain campaigns wherein he changed his faces and people had to actually recognize him, and people, those who were able to recognize him, would be given certain kind of you know, certain kind of goodies. Then in other you know films also certain campaigns were done. To the role of a distributor is again to recognize the sub distributor of the book or book theaters and send publicity material across to them. He also finalizes the TV and print media plan along with the marketing team. The entire distribution is, you know, the distribution marketing strategy is not only done on one particular platform, but here marketing and advertising department also, you know, they play a huge role, who work very closely along with the distributor of that particular film, and then they plan a proper marketing and advertising campaign in which they adopt a various amount of methods, maybe with the help of radio, television, certain, you know, games on the newspaper or any XYZ platform, wherein they certain times, you know, they give the free tickets, they, you know, so many campaigns are being run, different kind of marketing and advertising tools and techniques are being used. Then his also important role is to sign the agreements along with the theater people. Then he is also involved in the outdoor publicity, that is especially street, railway, hoardings, etc. Now, when we talk about the role of the distributor during the release week, earlier we discussed his role before the release of the film. Now it is during the release week of the film. Then his work is to collect the payments and dues, if any, from the people. Then second is that he also deals with the last minute booking. If any kind of theaters are interested in booking their film, then he's the one who's taking care of that last minute bookings. They also follow up for the show timings. Then they also, you know, they make sure that the preferable show timings are being given to their film, so that, you know, it is earning more amount of revenue as compared to the others. And then he also makes sure that the theater is listing, theater listing is available in the print media. Often we see in the newspaper, the, you know, information about the films are also given there. in Book My Show and other platforms. So he makes sure that the theater listing is there in the print media and electronic media, in digital media. Then supplying physical prints was used to be the role of a distributor during the release week, but nowadays it is all digital. So you know, they make sure that the digital prints are available. Then they also release the orders for the digital prints. This is also one of the important role. Now, after the release of the film, when the film is once released, his main role is to make sure that the net box, to calculate the net box office collection. Here, once we talk about box office collection, we simply mean that how many tickets are being sold on the box office. We are not talking about the film being watched on any other platform. We are not referring to the music being watched, music albums being sold. But here, simply we are trying to understand that how many tickets are being sold in any particular theater. So that is a net box office collection. Then we are also talking about the role of distributor post-release is to print the movement chart, to actually calculate whether if a film is doing well or not, the movement of the, sellings of the box office collections will give a clear picture whether the film is going to be there on the second week or third week or if it is not. Then if the movement chart is working in the progression line, then he also needs to make sure to keep the bookings for the second week and third week and how much it is required. Then billing process is usually done by the distributor post releasing of the film. And if there are any dues and refunds to be given, he makes sure that the refunds and dues are being collected and, refunds are being given. Then his main and important role is also to give a monthly business statements to the, producer of the film so that, they can create a chart that how much profit this film has earned and, to do all those chart and accounted activities to properly furnish their book of accounts. Then his important role is also to settle the accounts of debtors and creditors. And once the film is removed from earlier, this thing used to happen that when the prints were given to the particular theaters, in order to remove the piracy from the cinema market, it was the role of the distributor to destroy the prints. Right now, it is also the role of the distributor to destroy the digital prints that which has been given to the theaters. Then moving on to the next topic, that is non-theatrical rights, majorly focusing on the satellite rights right now. Here are the rights to the telecast of the film on the television we are focusing when we talk about satellite rights. Sometimes it happens that the film is released on the digital platform first, and sometimes it happens that the film is released on the television first. So here, when the rights to the telecast of the film is given on the television, we call them satellite rights, but they are not theatrical rights. The telecast is done after a minimum of 8 weeks from the time of the film is released in the cinemas. This is the minimum duration of the, time which is supposed to be followed. If the film is doing well, then the cinemas will keep on, pushing their dates, and then it would be there on the big screen. But if generally a film lasts for maximum 8 weeks on the cinema screen and then later on it is removed and then it comes to the television or other digital platforms. Then in most of the cases, the satellite telecast of the film is first before the telecast on any other platform. Any other platform, we are talking about digital platform here. The rights are heavily titled towards the talent attached with the film. The rights are also granted for a term of 10 years in the first cycle. The example of Suryavansham is best because we all are tired of seeing Suryavansham on that particular channel. Then key channels are Star Gold, Zee Cinema, Set Max and Colors. whenever any kind of film is being given with the satellite rights, they usually take it for 10 years of duration. And these are the major players who take the, you know, satellite rights of any film. That is Star Gold, Zee Cinema, Setmax and Colors. So, you know, non-theatrical rights, satellite rights also contribute to approx 17 to 18% of the overall revenues which are being earned by a film. Moving on to non-theatrical rights in the digital platform, here the role of the distributor is also to give the rights to telecast the film on the digital platform. As I earlier said, it has been, you know, with the changing trend in time, it has also being, you know, a matter of fact wherein the films are, you know, once removed from the cinema screen, they come to the digital platform first and then, you know, the on the television screen. So here the rule has become an additional source of revenue since the last 4 years with the launch of digital platforms like Netflix and Amazon Prime. At times, the telecast on the digital platform could precede the telecast on the satellite basis, the price paid to acquire. Then the rights are heavily titled towards the talent attached with the film. The rights are also granted for a term of approximately 5 to 7 years in the first cycle. And key players of the digital right holding companies are Amazon Prime, Netflix, Hotstar, Z5, etc. And these digital you know, platform contributes to approximately 11 to 12% of the entire revenue process. Moving on to satellite and digital cases. Now, these this particular you know, area is divided into three segments. It happens in the three possible ways. The first case is the satellite first. In this case, after a period of 8 weeks from the theatrical release, the film is telecasted on the satellite channel and post another 8 weeks on the digital platform, for example, Surma. Then in second case, here the digital comes first. In this case, after a period of 8 weeks from the theatrical release, the film is telecasted on the digital platform first and post another 8 weeks on the satellite channel, example, Film Rasi. Then the third case comes that the simultaneous on both satellite and digital platforms. In this case, after a period of 8 weeks from the theatrical release, the film is telecasted simultaneously both on satellite and digital platforms, example, Badhai Ho. Non-theatrical rights, music rights. Here, music is one of the most important, you know, area, because music is being liked by most of the people. There are certain times that the songs are specially made to put in that film, and it is because of the songs the, you know, films get a hype. Then these, you know, when we talk about music rights, they come into non-theatrical rights. And the rights to publish the music contributes to audio and video of the film on the different platforms, that is digital, TV and radio. Now here the music partnership begins right at the marketing cycle of the film. The music partner is most critical as they also help in promotion of the film. Like all the other non-theatrical rights, these rights are also heavily titled towards the talent which is attached with the film. The rights are also granted in perpetuity, and the key players in the musical field, you know, in the music companies are the T-Series, Z Music, Times Music, Sony Music, etc. They contribute to approximately 7 to 7.5% of the overall revenue which is earned by a film. Now, these are the following factors that influence the film pricing. Now, it is very important to understand how a film pricing is being done. The first point is cast of the film. Who are the major players? Who are the major actors in this particular film? Then we have the director, who is the director of the film. If the director of the film is a very renowned person, of course the pricing of the film will definitely go higher. Again, who is the banner which is producing this particular film? If it is Dharma Productions, if it is Yash Raj Productions, if it is Red Chilli Productions, Aamir Khan Films, Salman Khan Films, then these are going to be on a higher note. Even Phantom Films by Anurag Kashyap. Then what kind of genre these films are having? If it is having a rom-com, drama, then they are definitely going to be on a higher side. And if the music is already popular among the people, then the pricing of the film will also go high. Moving on to box office collection of the film, the gross box office, there are two type of box office collection. One is gross box office collection, which is also known as GBOC. Another one is net box office collection, that is NBOC. Now, gross box office collection is something which is, which is the amount which is collected at the time, at the ticket window when you purchase a ticket to watch a film. That simply means if you purchase a 500 rupees or a 300 rupees ticket, then if there are 100 people purchasing the same, ticket, so the total amount that the 30,000 is the gross box office collection. And when it comes to net box office collection, the amount collected after deducing the tax from the gross box office collection is net box office. For example, which is 12%. Earlier, it was entertainment tax. Right now, it is GST, which is equal to 12%. So if you remove the 12% from the 300 rupees, after removing that particular amount, the rest amount is our net box office collection. Then moving on to revenue sharing model. Here, revenue sharing model is important because the industry follows three major types of revenue sharing model in the film industry. The first one is minimum guarantee, second one is advance commission, and the third one is on the commission basis. When we talk about minimum guarantee is something wherein a particular set of amount is given, and after that, nobody is there in contact. Advance commission means simply means that a kind of a commission is given in advance, and on commission basis means that a particular set of amount of commission is being set, maybe related to 2 or 3% of the commission, and that's it, that's done. So these deals can be entered into between the producer and the distributor and the sub-distributor, sub-distributor and the exhibitor, and distributor, exhibitor in case of self-distribution. That simply means when I told you that certain times it happens that the producer are themselves the distributor. So the distributor and exhibitor means your theaters can also fall into the category of deals. Let us understand in detail that what is minimum guarantee. The first point that we have discussed here, the first type of revenue sharing model, that is minimum guarantee. Minimum guarantee is an initial sum or amount of money that is being paid to the producer by the distributor, irrespective of how the film performs. Whether if a film is a hit, whether if film flops, whether a film is not earning any amount of money, this much amount is given to the is paid to the producer by the distributor. So here the film again belongs to the distributor and producer has no role in that. Then overflow sharing means that the distributor first recoups his investment, then his commission of the minimum guarantee amount, and then splits the balance money, which is on the basis of the revenue split agreed with the producer. Then comes the advance commission. Here, in advance commission, it is a refundable advance payable by the distributor to the producer in lieu of the distribution rights of the film. In the case of the film does not do well, the producer refunds the part of the advances as per the agreement terms. And the overflow sharing is same as minimum guarantee deals. Then third point comes as commission. In the commission part, the distributor releases the film on behalf of the producer at a commission basis, and no advance amounts are being paid to the producer, unlike the earlier cases. The distributor charges his commission usually 10 to 12% of the distributor share, and the balance money is transferred to the producer. The overseas theatrical box office is heavily influenced by the star cast of the film. It contributes to approximately 14% of the total revenue of any Hindi mainstream film. The traditional market for the Hindi films are North America, Canada, United Kingdom, United Arab Emirates, Gulf countries. Earlier it used to be Pakistan, but right now there is not any more contract with the Pakistan. So Pakistan used to be a good source of revenue for the Hindi film industry, but now Pakistan is not any more part of it. Then we have Australia, New Zealand and Singapore. China is again an important source of revenue because it is becoming an important market in the recent times, with very few releasing, films releasing there. And these films also have a deferred release. This was all about, pricing and distribution in cinema management. Thank you so much for your time and patience. And if you have any doubt or queries, please feel free to ask me. My email ID is mentioned below. It is malvikasagar.27@gmail.com. Thank you so much for your time.